Neighborhood Health Watch is sponsored by the doctors of HCA Virginia.
Today in Neighborhood Health Watch, what women should know about cervical cancer. It occurs most often in women age 22 and older. Roughly 12,000 women get cervical cancer each year in the U.S., and doctors know the HPV, the human papilloma virus, is the main cause. Dr. Cecelia Boardman with Virginia Gynecologic Oncology and Henrico Doctors Hospital is here to explain more. Thanks a lot for joining us, Dr. Boardman. We do appreciate it. Now, HPV virus is a common virus that spread through sex from one person to another, but explain what cervical cancer is and how this virus leads to cervical cancer.
Approximately 85% of all American women have been exposed to HPV through their lifetime through skin-to-skin contact. The virus itself does not cause cancer in all women, but cancer of the cervix is cancer of the opening of the womb that's detected at the time of a pelvic exam.
And what are the guidelines in terms of testing that we should be adhering?
So there are new guidelines that have come out over the past few years that look at pap smear screening based on age every 3 to 5 years, depending on your age, and also at times in combination with HPV testing.
Well, what about women who have stopped having children? Should they also be tested?
Yes, you should continue to receive pap smears at least until age 65, unless you've had a hysterectomy.
And in terms of prevention, there are different types of prevention methods. What are the most common ones, and how successful are they?
Sure. Primary prevention through HPV vaccination for children ages 9 to 26 has been shown to be highly effective. And then in combination with that, secondary prevention through pap smear and HPV screening and treatment of precancerous lesions have been shown to be highly effective at preventing cervical cancer.
All right. Thank you so much again for joining us. We learned quite a bit.